Okay, thank you, Roy. Thank you, Ender, for the sharing. Hello, everyone. I'm Jackie. My name is Jiang Kuo. 12 years ago, I went for Singapore for my secondary school. And after that, I graduated from AIS. Then I became a game developer for 3 years, 3.5 years. Then I started my own business to produce VR games. So there's a one day my friend Shaohuan came look. Shaohuan has just brought a Oculus Rift GK2. So he asked me to do you want to develop a game, VR game, and together. So I say okay, let's do it. I always want to try new things. So then we start to think to pick what genre we are going to develop. So firstly, we want to develop the horror game, but none of us dare to develop the horror game, although we want to produce a horror game. And then after I think a while, then I realize I have a dream in my childhood. It's I want to be a scientist. So after I play so many games, I found after even you play the game, you enjoy the game for a period of time. But after you stop the game, you feel a little upset or lost because you didn't get much from the game. So I was thinking how about make some meaningful game, which is an educational game. So you bring the fun part into the game, and after you play the game, you have some feedback or some experience, and you learn something. So I started the education game VR project. So I quickly developed a demo during my part time. Then I found there's a competition in China held by UCCVR. So I just submit my game. Then after a period of time, I get the feedback. Say we have the second prize in the non game category. So then I realized it's time to set up a company and find some people who has the same interest and same dream as mine. So okay. So that's why I want to develop the. I want to make VR education company. This is a table of contents. First, I'm going to talk about why VR. And second part is our approach. How we make VR. We put VR technology into education. Third is other solutions currently exist in the market. Number four is challenges we in this VR education industry. So why VR education? So VR brings us the visibility. So you can compared to the 2D the book and videos, VR can bring us vivid objects. You can also there's an engagement. You can interact with the virtual object. You can pick it up and you can punch it. So there's a lot of interactions. And also VR gave us the safety. We want to experience new things. You don't need to go to the dangerous environment, and you don't need to do risky activities. You can just do it in the virtual environment. Lastly, VR also brings us the focus. One thing is different from VR to AR is you make the real world more exciting, and the VR is we can create completely different universe or space. So and this space is very immersive, and it's very it's a closed environment, so that you will not distract from the real world stuff. So it's a very good environment for the students to learn stuff. So, but what makes VR education special? So I have searched online. I found this story. There's a ancient Egypt clay tablet discovered, and there's a child written on it, and it says, "They beat me, and knowledge entered my head." So this is around 2,000 years ago. Actually, back in the old days, the learning education is driven by the motivation the punishment, the harsh punishment, and but the truth is the learning must come from yourself, come from the interest. So I believe the interest is the reason that can keep a person learning and keep learning. And this is the path. This is a really fun 2,000 years ago. So it's one teacher with three students. And this is a present. So it's found on the internet, and also one teacher with three students. So 2,000 years has passed. Nothing has changed much, right? So why is that so? I personally thought of this question. Then I realized it's previously in the past, right? Some other people experienced something, then they summarize as knowledge. Then they read into the book, and they took picture, and they took video, and they try to record down this knowledge. Then the others will have to read the book, read the picture, and to understand this knowledge, and to eventually apply it to the real world. So the whole process is from the 3D environment to 2D book or 2D images, and the reader will still have to convert back to 3D. So this process is there's a conversion loss. So let's say if somebody has a very limited imagination maybe IQ, then during this process he might be lost, and that's why not everyone will have a good result, because there is a conversion loss during this information or knowledge transmission process. And now we have VR. VR enable us the chance to experience yourself. And last time all the experience is a second hand experience, and now in VR, so everything you play, you try, you interact with is your experience, is a first hand experience. Then you can easily understand and help to memorize it, then and apply it. So the whole process is a 3D to 3D conversion. So there's no very little conversion loss. So that's why I think the VR is more effective in terms of transmission knowledge or information. So at VR education, they provide us first-hand knowledge and no conversion loss, and I believe it's a future of the education. And okay, so now is our approach. How are we going to develop those education VR? So one direction is you create a game environment. You use some tricks in the game commercial game, so such as leaderboard, the social networking, and mini games. So our product is a role playing game with interactions, and the platform is using HTC Vive and the Gear VR. So it's a self-learning process, and there's a story background story, and there are mini games, and there are quests. So and it's a VR game, and the content you want to deliver is from the school. The teacher in China, the school collaborating with us. The teacher will come out with ideas. How are they going to teach this lesson? So we implement all those ideas into our game. So and we can sell this self-learning game to the app, to the Steam store and Gear VR to monetize it. And the other way is we implement the education contents in the full-time education. It's just the schools and the tuition centers. So currently, in the schools, you have a number of students and one teacher. So you need to engage them all into the same virtual trip or virtual environment. So the teacher and the students will come to, will go anywhere in this virtual universe, and teachers will have teachers can control the pace and the point of interest. So let's say in the HTC Vive version, in the multiplayer version, the teacher can become a giant, and the students all dwarfs. So the teacher will ask the student to follow him, or if one student is not listening to the teacher, the teacher can pick him up and put him into the correct direction or point. So and the teacher can trigger the event. Trigger something to happen, and can control NPCs and control the students. And it's not a replacement for the current teaching method. It's just a extra stuff, and it's a tool for the teacher to attract students' interest, and to make sure the knowledge is can be delivered in an efficient way. And this is our demo to show the interaction and some okay, so the background of this one is Arctic region. So the student will be put onto the green line. So and this character will introduce him some the knowledge or some facts, and play some games with a pair with a student.
Thank you.
that's the very raw demo of our game. We'll keep the keep trying these two directions, and we are also trying many small demos. We do some we'll make virtual space just for the students to do physics or chemistry experiments. Those are very dangerous experiments, and those are very harsh environment, like the vacuum or the space in the zero gravity environment. So we can all conduct the experiment in those virtual world. And there are other solutions in the market, such as Google expeditions. From this their approach is a little bit different from us. They are using 360 videos and in the class, so there will be there are good and pros and cons of 360 video. One is the pros is there's a lack of interaction, and the cons is the graphic will be realistic, and development of content is relatively fast. And the other one is called Apollo 11 VR. So this educational content is you enable the player to travel to the moon and aboard to the spaceship, just like the Apollo 11 did. So you are one of the spaceman. And the other one is called Labster. This one is software. It's a VR software to simulate the very expensive and dangerous laboratory and all the devices. So this Labster can enable the university to conduct dangerous experiment and to save money. And there are also challenges in this VR educational development industry. The most difficult part is the proper structuring, which is how you tell the story, how you make the story into a game, or you put the fun part into some boring knowledge. This one is the most difficult part we face right now. And the other one is efficient content development. As I say, if you want to generate whole universe out of nothing, so you need a lot of talents. Compared to the 360 video, you just you need a cameraman and the device. You can quickly develop the content. If it's a totally virtual world, you need to start from scratch. So the efficiency is also a thing we need to consider. The last one is expensive hardwares. So most of the VR hardwares, if you want you want to have enable interactions, and you want to have more immersive experience, the cost will be very high. So that is another problem we are facing. So we believe greater accessibility of VR devices can overcome these challenges, and VR will eventually revolutionize education in the future. Thank you.
Thank you. So if there's anybody who is like in the education industry and would like to explore more on education in VR, feel free to just approach Jackie later outside.
Do you see any improvement in memory retention for students that have a teacher in front of them talking, or students that are actually interacting with the environment? Do you see a difference in what they can remember?
Yeah. The difference between a teacher compared to the virtual teacher or virtual avatar.
after a week, after a month, they remember better the VR experience rather than the teacher?
Personally, I can feel the difference because in the real if you learning from you are learning from a real teacher, then sometimes you encounter someone you don't like, right? So if you don't like this teacher, then I think the whole subject you'll be screwed. So and in the virtual avatar, there's no such thing because we can always let the user to choose the avatar he like, and you choose the avatar you like, then this avatar will get through the whole learning process. So this is another way to improve the efficiency of the education, to try to make sure the human factor will not affect this education.
But with a teacher, a student can ask a question. So do you create enough possibilities in the environment that a student can actually interact with a possible question, or do you just create a single experience?
Just now, as I mentioned, we have two product lines. One is for single player self-learning. So this one, you may not ask question because we don't have maybe enough database to answer you. But for the full-time education, there's always a real teacher play with you and answer your question at any time. Thank you.
Expect much more of the application of those technologies for the children. Okay, so my first question is whether that by wearing these goggles for a long time, there will be some concern for the eyesight of the children. Whether that you have done some research on how long time that the content is good for the children to take.
That's probably the most frequent question I will be asked. The things are all the electronic device, if you don't use it properly and you use in the wrong way, that will to some extent they will cause the stress to your eyes. Like for example, the smartphone, right? If you keep playing for half a day, play online games, so you definitely will feel stress, and you will feel the drop of your eyesight. So in VR, it's the same thing. So if you use this one correctly, and you keep you don't play for long time, and because currently all the VR HMD, they have the function to adjust the focus, make sure you have relief feeling, and you have the best eyesight. So if you get your of course the students need to get it on how to use the HMD. Once they learn, they will know how to adjust for their best experience.
So actually my second question is a little bit similar, but from the another point of view is as the parent, one can say that I don't like to have my children to be exposed to those electronic devices so frequently, and also the risk is that they are addicted to this kind of games in a virtual environment. So I don't know whether that this happened to your business journey or not, whether there is some concern expressed by the children's parents.
Definitely. There definitely will. There will always be parents who are very concerned about this new technology. Whether this new technology will be addictive, or will this one will affect their results. But our product is we are going to improve your results by improve the efficiency of transmission of the knowledge by. Getting the first-hand experience. So I think that once the market is educated enough, there are results come out from the students who played VR games using the VR technology to learn. The parents will see the results in the future, and the yeah.
Thank you so much.